Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not Rich Kleinfeld. I'm Alan Cole, a stand-in from the horn section. Rich is under the weather. He sends his regards, and we're wishing him a speedy recovery. Tonight, we say goodbye to another season of music and to our music director of nearly 30 years. We also celebrate the youth in music with a performance featuring the 2023 Young Artist Competition winner, clarinetist Tyler Anderson. It's a wonderful evening of music. Our opening selection is by Kenneth Amis, a tuba-playing composer who began pursuing his deep interest in music in his teens. His passion for playing and composing continued to grow as he gained more knowledge and encouragement, particularly at the New England Conservatory. The Spring Overture is a 2018 commission in honor of the 85th birthday of renowned teacher and conductor Frank Battisti. In the composer's words, I can honestly say that Frank Battisti gave my career as a professional composer the momentum it needed to get off the ground. His passion, drive, and unwavering professionalism still set a shining example. Music by Kenneth Amis, Spring Overture.
Thank you.
The next selection, Wings and Shield, was composed by Jerry Brubaker, a longtime member of the City of Fairfax Band horn section. Wings and Shield was written for Jerry's high school band trumpet-playing buddy, Drew Griffin. In 1964, Drew went to the United States Coast Guard Academy, while Jerry studied music theory and horn at Eastman School of Music. After service in Vietnam, Drew continued to search and rescue, mostly in the H-3 Pelican helicopter. Jerry was accepted into the United States Navy Band as a French horn soloist and staff arranger. Fast forward 30 years as Drew retires as chief of staff of the 8th Coast Guard District. Jerry decided to write a march to be played at Captain Griffin's retirement ceremony by the United States Coast Guard Band, Captain Lou Buckley, Jerry Brubaker's college chum, conducting. This march is dedicated to all those men and women who perform air, sea, search and rescue in the United States Coast Guard. Please enjoy as the City of Fairfax Band performs Wings and Shield. Our next music features the 2023 City of Fairfax Band Young Artist Competition winner, Tyler Anderson. This talented clarinet player is a junior at West Springfield High School. Throughout high school, Tyler has been a member of his school wind symphony and the American Youth Philharmonic. Since elementary school, he has kept music in his life, playing piano, saxophone, trumpet, and clarinet. In addition to winning our award, Tyler placed in various other competitions, the Friday Morning Music Club, the 2023 U.S. Army Orchestra Competition, and the American Youth Philharmonic Concerto Competition. This evening, we'll hear him perform the Concerto for Clarinet by American jazz clarinetist, composer, and bandleader Artie Shaw. Artie wrote it in 1940. As you'll hear, it's a challenging, lively, and enjoyable piece of music. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm welcome to our soloist winner, Tyler Anderson. Thank you.
This has always been one of my favorite nights of the year. I did some quick math a little while ago. This competition started in 1996. Started off as a $1,000 prize for a few years, and then we were able to increase it to two. So we're coming up on $50,000 of awards that we've made through this program over the years. Tyler, that was great. So the award will come, somebody else will hand you the real part of the award. That's the check part, you know. But I do want to give you this certificate suitable for framing that you can hang up. This just simply certifies that Tyler Anderson is the 2023 Young Artist Competition winner for the City of Fairfax Band.
As we realized at our most recent previous City of Fairfax Band concert, it is unlikely that we will ever run out of musical choices from John Williams. In addition to concert works, he has composed for 75 films and at age 91 is not ready to retire. And there's a note here from Rich Kleinfeld that says, I also learned that this is one of Bob Pouliot's favorite scores. Jedi Steps and Finale comes from the blockbuster 2015 Star Wars film, The Force Awakens. The action starts 30 years after the Galactic Civil War. The music evokes the dramatic climax of the film, followed by the explosive finale.
Thank you.
First of all, man, here we go. I'm on, right? Here we go. First of all, I want to say thank you to Alan Cole for pinch hitting for Rich Kleinfeld tonight. Alan also wrote those program notes during your program. He's been a long time background historian for the band. That march, his honor, is the first piece I ever conducted with the City of Fairfax Band 29 years ago. And just very quickly about this program, on this half of the program, the last two pieces of this program, along with his honor, made up my audition concert almost exactly 29 years ago. I always had it in mind that on this night that's what I'd finish with. As far as the rest of the program, I really was looking for things that showed off the versatility of this group and all the different kinds of music we played over the year, film music and marches, of course. Always something new, that was Spring Overture. So I wanted to make sure that we show that off tonight. And this next piece, Foundation, is very special for us. And I need to talk about it a little bit and set it up for you a little bit. Even if Rich were here tonight, I told Rich ahead of time, I want to talk about this piece. A good number of these people, not everybody on stage, but a good number of these people are coming to Orlando next week. This is not quite my last concert with the band. It's my last subscription series concert. We're playing for the Association of Concert Bands National Convention next week in Orlando. And I knew going to that convention that I wanted to take Foundation. We have commissioned many works over the years that I've been with this group, but this one is very special. And the reason that we're doing this is because this is, the whole story behind this piece is what community bands are all about. And I'm going to ask you to bear with me on two things. One, I'm going to talk a little bit, so I'll be talking for a few minutes. Number two, if I get emotional, give me a minute to breathe. Okay. The year 2002 was incredible highs and incredible lows for this organization. We started the year off just coming off of 9/11. So we were still the whole world was trying to recover from that. We, as an organization, were working toward hosting what in 2002 was the Association of Concert Bands Convention in Fairfax in May. And you can imagine what we thought when 9/11 hit and, oh my, what's going to happen? You know, a lot of people still a year later were very reluctant to travel. And through the efforts of this whole band pulled together, it was a tremendous success. And it was led, that whole effort was led by a very special gentleman who had been president of the band for, I believe, about 14 years at that point. His name was Ray Abel. And a lot of you out there remember Ray Abel. Ray was a retired commercial electrician, and he lived and breathed City of Fairfax Band. It was his full-time job. He did everything. He did everything to the extent that all I worried about was the music. He did all. He was the City of Fairfax Band, along with his wife, Cheryl. They made a great team. She was kind of like his executive secretary and did everything and baked really great cookies and breakfast for Saturday morning board meetings and all kinds of stuff. Ray had a dream, and that dream was he wanted to see a full standing room only audience. And our normal rehearsal performance venue is at Fairfax High School, so that means 1,100 plus people. December 21st of 2002, that happened. We had about 1,350 people packed into that 1,100 seat hall, came this close to the fire marshal saying, no, you're shut down now. Mayor John Mason was walking up and down the halls finding people's seats. It was a magical night. And 2 days later, quite suddenly and quite unexpectedly, Ray Abel passed away. Cheryl, And I won't go into all the things that happened immediately right after, but one of the things that Cheryl did was she asked that a fund be established called the Ray Abel New Music Fund. And she thought it was something that people would contribute to when we'd buy some new arrangements to play in the summertime. In no time at all, that fund had $5,000 plus in it. And I thought, we need to do something special. So I had this idea of, let's find a Virginia composer, let's approach the Virginia Commission on the Arts, let's say we've got the seed money, let's do a matching grant, let's do a piece in Ray's honor. I knew the composer I wanted to approach was Mark Campos. And Mark, you're here tonight, right? There he is. Okay. Mark at the time, was on the faculty at Radford University, and I contacted him. We talked, and they said, you know, told him the whole background of the story, and Mark said, it sounds like a great idea. I'd love to do the commission. I'd love to work with you. Forget about the grant. You'll never get it. It's been tried before and never been done. Okay. So I'm going to say again, through the efforts of some people in this group that worked very hard on that, it was the first time that we applied for a Virginia Commission on the Arts grant, and we got it. We went back and called Mark and said, okay, we're on, we're doing this. And one of the things that Mark did was have lots of conversations with Cheryl and Sherry Stegman, his daughter, who plays in the band, lots of conversations with them about Ray's favorite things, what Ray liked. And after a time, we decided that one thing that had to be part of this piece was a hymn called Be Still My Soul. And some of you would know that as the Sibelius Finlandia hymn, because that was one of Ray's favorites. That was his brass group he played with in church. That was their two-minute filler whenever they needed something on the program. And so we kind of let it be at that, and of course we weren't on Mark's calendar yet, so time went on. And then something really, really eerie happened. Mark was visiting a college in the Midwest, guest conducting, walking around the campus late one night and wandered into the chapel, and in the sanctuary was a grand piano with the light shining down on it, and the hymnal open on the music desk. And he couldn't resist temptation, so he walked up, looked at the hymnal, and it was open to a hymn called How Firm a Foundation, which he was not familiar with. And he started playing with it and working with it a little bit and thought, And he came back and he called Cheryl and he said, do you know the hymn How Firm a Foundation? And Cheryl said, that was one of Ray's favorite hymns. So you're going to hear How Firm a Foundation. You're going to hear Be Still My Soul. Worked into this piece. When this piece was published, and I have to say, we're very proud of the fact that this piece has been published. This piece has literally been performed by community, college, military, professional bands all over the world since it was published. The outer parts are based on those two hymns. You're going to hear, I'll just say, you'll hear sometimes disguised a little bit, but you hear those hymns. And toward the end, you're also going to hear a little bit of Shenandoah, and that's a nod to Ray's country home out in the Shenandoah Valley. And toward the very end, a trumpet duet, two trumpets and a flute trio playing these melodies together. And that's supposed to be Ray and Cheryl and Sherry. The middle part of the piece, total contrast to the outer parts, is there because, as Cheryl told Mark, above all, Ray liked a good peppy tune. So this is Mark Campos's Foundation.
Thank you.
we learn lots about the composers themselves from their major works, their symphonies. The composition may come at an important time in their lives. In the case of Dmitri Shostakovich, it was a critical time. Shostakovich wrote his Fifth Symphony to save his skin. Soviet dictator Joseph Stalin hated Shostakovich's opera, Lady Macbeth of Msensk District. Salvation for Shostakovich was his Symphony No. 5, which he subtitled, A Soviet Artist's Practical Creative Reply to Just Criticism. It took Shostakovich just 3 months to write and orchestrate the Fifth Symphony. The jubilant reception it received restored the composer's status as a Soviet national artistic hero. That was Shostakovich's public comment. Privately, he still knew that this music was greater than any one person or government. Here is the finale to the Symphony No. 5 by Dmitri Shostakovich.
Thank you.
Irving Berlin came to the United States with his family at the age of 5. He was musically inclined, but basically self-taught, and allegedly did not read music. In spite of that, he had a 60-year successful career with more than 1,500 published songs, many of those big hits. Just to mention a few, I'm sure you'll know, White Christmas, Easter Parade, God Bless America. And from God Bless America, all the royalties go to the Boy Scouts of America. Warren Barker has created a tribute to Irving Berlin that you might still be humming long after the concert.
Thank you.
we would like for Jean-Pierre Offret, City of Fairfax Band Association Board Chair, to come to the stage, please.
Thank you, and thank you, Bob, for your 29 years. And reflecting upon that time, in some ways it seems like an instance, but in other ways, if you look at the mileposts, it seems like quite a long time, and a great tribute to being able to navigate 29 years leading an organization such as this. Back in 1994, when Bob joined, some of the significant events of the time, Nelson Mandela was elected president of South Africa. Back then, NAFTA was recently enacted. There were some interesting politicians around the world. Bill Clinton, John Major, Helmut Kohl, Francois Mitterrand, Boris Yeltsin. Our governors here were Douglas Wilder and George Allen. And in technology, which is a real milepost, Steve Jobs was still at Next back then. Tim Berners-Lee just invented the World Wide Web. Jeff Bezos just founded Amazon. Wow, that was a long time ago. The first book, interestingly enough, sold over Amazon was an artificial intelligence book. And AOL used the floppy disk to sign up to load the software. TV, the shows were Friends, Seinfeld, ER were the main ones. Murder, She Wrote was another one. And the movies, Forrest Gump and Lion King. And so at that time, with all this happening in the world, Bob joined the City of Fairfax Band Association. We've often discussed at the board that in many ways we are very much like the U.S. Air Force organizationally. And so we're very appreciative that Bob joined. And Bob, over the years, working with the wonderful musicians and membership, City of Fairfax, Arts Fairfax, Virginia Commission for the Arts, and our wonderful private sector partners such as Sandy Spring Bank and Gingrich Foundation have really brought increased in amount of music that they brought to the City of Fairfax and to the region, adding multiple ensembles, including the Main Street Community Band with Jeff Sessions, the Youth Winds really expanding our age groups, and you saw the wonderful performance by the scholarship winner tonight with the clarinet, and a number of smaller ensembles. We now have over 100 performances a year, and a great, great credit to Bob. The band has expanded internationally through D-Day, the music commissions with wonderful composers such as Mark Camphouse, and it's brought many, many awards, both organizationally, such as the Sudler Award, and to Bob as an outstanding composer. Ultimately, though, even with these organizational advances, Bob's legacy and contributions really are represented by our programs, and especially several pages in it. This page here has the players, the musicians, and you can see the number of years that many of the musicians have stayed with City of Fairfax Band and the Band Association. Bob has been able to create a family amongst the association with the musicians, and also as through the program, a community here in the region with the City of Fairfax and with the other community arts organizations. And then lastly, also with the program and with the many, many musicians and Broadway performers and different types of performances Bob has put on, ultimately it's been about the music. So many thanks, Bob, and congratulations, and thank you for all your contributions. I'd now like to introduce Mayor Catherine S. Read. Newly became mayor-elected last November, and a long-time Fairfax resident, 22, might be 23 years now. Catherine is a graduate of George Mason, also was very early creating a company called Creative Read, helping small businesses with social media way back in 2007. I'm not even sure it was called social media then. Catherine has three children who graduated from City of Fairfax High. And then lastly, has a vision for the city becoming more of a destination city, a wonderful place to live and work, but also a small city known for innovation and imagination. So welcome, Mayor Weed.
Thank you so much. This is my honor to read the proclamation that we We read at Tuesday City Council meeting, I am the new mayor of the city of Fairfax, and I must give a nod to the two previous mayors of Fairfax City, David Meyer and John Mason, who are with us tonight. Former city council member Ellie Schmidt said to me years ago that a budget is nothing more than a list of your priorities. And former Mayor Meyer and former Mayor John Mason have made the arts in Fairfax City a priority. It is a community value here. And I am assuming the stewardship of the mayors who've gone before me to make certain that the City of Fairfax Band Association will always be a priority here in the city. The words in this proclamation can't begin to honor this man for three decades of leadership, stewardship, and vision for the music they have brought to this city. 100 concerts a year represents not just thousands of hours of joy that have been brought to our community, but there's thousands of hours of practice and rehearsal and hundreds of people who've sat in these chairs over the last 29 years, committed to their passion, to their vision, and bringing it to us, the grateful recipients. Without further ado, whereas Mr. Robert Pouliot has led the City of Fairfax Band Association, a vibrant and vital quality of life asset of this city, whose music making has filled the hearts of so many people in so many places for the past 29 years. And whereas during his tenure with the association, he established the Young Artists Competition, the Northern Virginia Youth Winds, and the Main Street Community Band in order to engage young musicians and provide additional opportunities for adult musicians to share their love of music. And whereas he continued the City of Fairfax traditional concert performances, including the Independence Day celebration in the parade and the evening show, and recently the city's hometown celebration for Independence Day, the 9/11 memorial services, and many swearing-in ceremonies for the mayor, city council, and school board members. And whereas, under his 29-year leadership, conducting skill, and musicality, the association and each musician has flourished, which has brought much notoriety, including invitations to perform at major band conferences and celebrations, such as the 2017 D-Day commemoration ceremonies in Normandy and Saint-Mère Église, France. And whereas, because of the association's enhanced notoriety over the past 29 years, notable guest artists have accepted invitations to perform with the City of Fairfax Band, including renowned conductor Frederick Fennell, Disney's music director James Christensen, Broadway singers, National Symphony Orchestra musicians, and many more who contributed to enhancing artistic performances enjoyed by concert patrons. And whereas he commissioned 13 original music compositions by major American composers and emerging composers, many of which are available for high school, college, and community bands through established music publishers. And whereas he continued to provide music to the community through three virtual performances during the COVID-19 pandemic that entertained residents of the City of Fairfax and the greater community. And whereas Robert Pouliot's exceptional service to music and to the community have rightly gained him recognition, including the John Mason Arts Achievement Award from the City of Fairfax Commission on the Arts and the Association of Concert Bands Outstanding Conductor Award, as well as recognitions for the City of Fairfax Band, such as the John Philip Sousa Sudler Scroll Award. Now, therefore, I, Catherine S. Read, Mayor of the City of Fairfax, in concert with the City Council, do hereby give sincerest congratulations to Robert Pouliot for his 29 years of musical entertainment to the City of Fairfax, providing enjoyment, enrichment, and enhancements of arts to this community.
We would like for Linda Sullivan, President and Chief Executive Officer of Arts Fairfax, to join us.
Thank you so much. Thank you for inviting me to be here tonight. This is really special. Arts Fairfax has funded the City of Fairfax Band for many years, and tonight showed everybody why. Fabulous concert. Thank you so much. Everybody did such a wonderful job. I find it interesting that there was sort of an arts renaissance in the 60s in Fairfax, the Fairfax area. And we assume that the suburbs were growing, and it's an indication that people want something civic in their lives. They want culture, they want the arts, and the City of Fairfax Band was one of a handful that still exists today. So you all have been doing something mighty fine. You're clearly so important to your community and so integral. And you, Bob, you have been at the helm and a leading light for half of this organization's life. And in that time, you have expanded your programs. You've expanded the number of people who have participated. And you've expanded the recognition of the organization and all the accolades. And so the organization, you deserve all the accolades you're getting tonight. I think it's so important to recognize the talent and the dedication that so many of our arts leaders bring to the community. Bob, none more so than you. So I just want to say congratulations, and congratulations to the band, and y'all are fabulous.
Community music is a family affair, and that especially goes for the City of Fairfax Band. Louise Pouliot, would you please join us on stage?
Besides all the people you see on stage, there's lots of people that play cameo roles in an organization of this size. I'm Eric Lindberg, the president of the association. And one of the people that clearly had played a cameo role for 29 years was Louise. So here we would like to present these flowers in recognition of all of your cameo roles that you played throughout all of the years. We truly, truly appreciate it. We would also like to everybody's waiting for cake, so hold on just a minute. We also like to recognize the rest of the Pouliot family. Please stand up and be recognized there.
One more introduction. Rick Perrell, the associate conductor of the City of Fairfax Band.
I'll make this brief. Bob, I hope you don't mind that I showed up tonight for the concert, even though my name wasn't in the program. So. Anyway, on behalf of the members of the Fairfax City Band, it is my great honor to present this photo of the band, and hopefully everybody has autographed it. And this band wouldn't be what it is today without you. All these 30 years, and whoever takes over this band, they're going to have a hard time equaling what you have done for the band. So.
Thank you.
promise. First of all, 29 years, Rick Perrell, 53. Thank you. Your name doesn't need to be in the program. Everybody knows who you are. But no, it is in there on the program page. Look at it. Thank you so much, all of you, for everything, for the accolades, for the recognition. It has been my honor to work with this group all of these years. For Louise and for my family, you don't know how many times it was, happy birthday, going to rehearsal now. Happy anniversary, see you later. You know, there was a lot of those over the last 29 years, so thank you, all of you, for your support of me and everything I've done. And that's all I really want to say. I hear there's cake, I guess. So thank you all so much for everything you've done and for your support.